both the positive and negative feedback are how they are going to help us out. And we have seen that this the fundamental principle of oscillators, right? Started off with the oscillators. We saw that the fundamental principle behind oscillation is the positive feedback, which happens from, you know, there's a round trip gain, which we ensure, if we ensure the round trip gain of the feedback to be higher than 1, then we can ensure that the oscillations will sustain. Moreover, there should also be a zero phase shift of that round trip gain, right? Meaning, the Barkhausen criteria must be satisfied. What was the Barkhausen criteria? Well, to quote in one line, this should be equal to, 1. This is the Barkhausen. That's it. What does it mean? The round trip gain must be higher than 1, or 1 to be ideal. 1 doesn't exist. So we always, for practical applications, we always keep the round trip gain to be higher than 1. And the phase shift, okay, the phase shift must be 0, or it should be an integer multiple of 2 pi. Alright, so let's go ahead. Now, in order to achieve this, we already know a structure which can give 180 degree of phase shift, right? Any CE amplifier, or if it is a common source amplifier, it gives 180 degree phase shift. We are just left with the another 180 degree phase shift, and we need to ensure that this A beta is 1. If we ensure that, we can guarantee that the oscillations will sustain, right? So it's like this. Say for example, again let me take that block. Yesterday we saw that this A, if I'm having a signal XI and this is a feedback network beta, and these are not connected initially, we assume that, right? Let this be B, this be A, I mean AB are the points, let this be P1 and P2. Let this be XI, we said that this XI is getting multiplied here by A and B, so the round trip gain becomes AB, and if we ensure that, and of course there is an inversion there, if this XI is small enough and A beta is higher than 1, okay, is if A beta is higher than 1 and the phase shift is 0, what would happen? If there is a initial small seed of the signal XI, that is going to be amplified by A beta, that is going to again be amplified by A beta, and so on, and it will go on amplification until the non-linearity of the circuit is playing role in bounding this amplitude of the oscillations. Alright, so practically the non-linearity comes into the picture. Non-linearity of what? Non-linearity of the amplifiers comes into the picture, and these oscillations won't go beyond bound. Alright, so it all starts with a small seed, and we said that the moment this is created, we simply join this, we simply join this 2 points. In an essence, it is like this. Without giving any signal, it is creating the oscillations. That was the, you know, main fundamental concept of the oscillators. Without giving the input, we are getting the output, we are generating the output. Now there are several questions here. What could be the output shape? I mean, I said that it might not be sinusoidal in nature, it might not have a specific shape, but if we ensure that the initial phase frequency and the amplitude, if the initial phase frequency and amplitude is maintained, then we can ensure the oscillations that we want, okay, desired kind of oscillations can be generated. So the main fundamental, suppose let's assume that we want to get sinusoidal oscillations, then in that case we need to maintain the amplitude, phase and frequency of the initial signal, and assume that we have such kind of signals. Now let's come back to one kind of one such circuit which can give us such kind of oscillations. Consider this circuit. Well, I'll take MOS in. I may take BJT also, okay, just because the circuit will be easy. And this is given, well, not here. In order to avoid confusion, I could mark this. I'm making a claim that this circuit which I'm drawing is capable of generating oscillations of specific frequency. Okay, the frequency and the frequency of oscillations is such that we can manually tune that. Let this be some R. Well, not R here, but there should be C here. These are the capacitors. It's like a three-stage RC network. R here, same R, C, C, C. So these capacitors are having same values. These R, all the R's are the same. Let this be VCC or VDD. Let this be RD. Gate, source, and drain. Well, if this is a common source, you know that. No, concentrate here. Observe. See, I'm claiming that this kind of circuit can provide oscillations. Then, of course, this kind of circuit should satisfy the Barkhausen criteria. Now, we know that this common source amplifier gives 180 degree phase shift. Can you have a look at the formula of the gain? That is minus GM RD. You know that? That is minus GM RD. You know that?
Yeah. this is rainy season. Okay, for rainy season, the taking money will be efficient from this pump source amplifier. Then we should make sure you want to increase it. You don't want any kind of phase difference. You know that why we don't want to phase difference? Just because the original signal should not be distorted. It should be the same way. Then it is going to be amplified and so on, and then it will be very obvious. Okay, it should be always clear. In the case, the start point is like this. Of course, by the end, if it is, this is how it is, that is what it is taking. After it is coming here, it should have the same phase. That means it will actually start from zero distance. The first signal starting from the one distance, then again, it should back start from the one distance. If it is the case from this, then the operations are not going to be different. Alright, so if you want, zero degree phase shift or 360 degree or vertical up to pi. You know that this guy is going to give you 180 degree phase shift. And we expect that the other network, the remaining network, should give us 180 degree phase shift, right? We should design this IRC circuit in such a way that we should get a 180 degree phase shift there. Alright? We should, yeah.
Therefore, we want this. Now, let me come back to the circuit. In this circuit, here's the output, right? Here's the output. If you remember the diagram, the block diagram, this A, here it is V out, right? What is this? Can you tell me? V F. You know, out is going back at the input, and at the output we are getting VF, right? So this beta is nothing but a feedback network, and here I am measuring VF. So this V out by VF, VF by V out, right? VF by V out should give me 180 degree of phase shift. Is that okay? So the output of feedback network by its input should give me a phase shift of how much? 180 degree. Now let's come back to this circuit, and I'm claiming that this is possible with this kind of RC network. Okay, let's come back to this net later. First, let me mark this. So this is the feedback network that we are going to see. So everything, the designing and all, lies between this feedback network. If we are designing it in such a way that, you know, we want, let's say, 1 megahertz of oscillation, 2 megahertz of oscillation, then it all depends on this RC network. Alright, so let's see one RC network so that you will be confident, and then we'll move back, we'll go slowly with this. So consider a very simple RC network. Take this example, then you'll come to know. Take this example. I don't have over. Yeah, take this example. No, see, I'm not taking RC, a proper RC network. I'm just proving that RC can provide some kind of phase shift. Do you all know that? Are you aware that RC network provides any phase shift? Huh? Can you prove that? Can you prove that? Yes, by phasor diagram. Or can you prove that by an expression? Can you tell me for what frequency it is going to provide the phase shift and all? So let's start with that. Okay. So consider this. I'm considering the simple two-stage RC network. I may consider one stage also, but one is not going to give any benefit. So let this be capacitor, let this be R, again let this be capacitor there, and then R there. What should I write here? Huh? Is that okay? Fine. The output of the amplifier, and this is the output of the feedback network we have. This is VR. Now, what you do is you calculate the ratio VF upon V0. Can you do that? Can you do that? How? Just go for failure. Just to begin with, you can, first of all, you should note that R is in ohms. C is not in ohms,
Alright? So you should convert that to ohms. How will you do that? Yeah? Omega C, right? J omega. You should not forget that J. That is very important.
Yes, yes. I mean, in I'll write this, I'll just replace this, the C with what is called as 1 upon SC, where S is nothing but J omega. Alright?
Replace that. Now that is in ohms.
Life is simple, okay? See here. कैसे करोगे? देखो यहाँ पे दो तीन तरीके हैं. Thevenin's पता है? दो तरीके हैं. एक तरीका मैं बताता हूँ, दूसरा तरीका आप सबको करना. ठीक है? सिंपल तरीका क्या करूँगा मैं? बोलो. लगाओ KVL. I. अपने को क्या चाहिए? V out, VF by V out, right? लगाओ KVL. I. Two. VF क्या होगा? I two into R. राइट लगाओ केवीएल क्या होगा पहले लूप में केवीएल लगाओ कितना फोर इक्वल्स टू बोलो प्लस माइनस लिखो प्लस माइनस दैट्स इट हाँ बोलो आई आई वन माइनस हो गया ना इक्वल्स टू लिख दिया मैंने हाँ वन अपॉन एस सी इंटू आई वन माइनस आई जिस लूप में है वो करंट बड़ा ठीक है, उसके बाद लगाओ केवीएल आई टू में, दूसरे लूप में, लूप टू, दिस लूप वन, दिस लूप टू, बोलो जीरो इक्वल्स टू, बोलो वन अपॉन एस सी आई टू माइनस आई वन प्लस वन अपॉन एस सी आई टू प्लस आर आर आई टू, दैट्स इट, ठीक है,
ओके। अरे देखा है ना, देखा है केवीएल,
ओके वेरी गुड। नाउ दिस विल गिव यू अ मैट्रिक्स डेल, व्हाट इज डेल, डेल इज डेल्टा, सो दिस इज गोइंग टू बी हाउ मच इज दिस आर 1 upon, well, you should simplify this further. Collect the terms. क्या आएगा? R I 1 plus I 1 upon minus I 2 upon S C. So this I am going to combine. So this is going to be what? बोलो वन अप आई वन टाइम्स आर प्लस वन अपॉन एस सी, ये क्या होगा बोलो, आई वन के टर्म्स बोलो, हाँ माइन वन अपॉन एस सी टाइम्स आई वन, आई टू के टर्म्स बोलो प्लस आर प्लस, हाँ सॉरी यस टू बाय एस सी आई, ठीक है आई वन आई टू मैट्रिक्स बन गया, बनाओ मैट्रिक्स डेल डेल्टा इक्वल्स टू, बोलो क्या आएगा, आर प्लस वन अपॉन एस सी पहली टर्म, दूसरी टर्म बोलो माइनस वन अपॉन एस सी, तीसरी टर्म माइनस वन अपॉन एस सी, चौथी टर्म आर प्लस टू बाय एस सी, राइट। अभी अपने को चाहिए क्या, आई टू चाहिए ना, क्योंकि आई टू इंटू आर विल बी वी एफ, राइट। सो डेल टू निकालो, डेल टू, डेल टू मतलब सेकेंड कॉलम रिप्लेस करोगे किससे, इससे, बोलो वी अपॉन जीरो, यहाँ पे ऐसा क्या ऐसा वन अपॉन एस सी माइनस वन अपॉन एस सी, कैलकुलेट डेल टू अपॉन डेल, करो फटाफट,
ये देखा नहीं देखा हमने, दो पता है नहीं पता बदल गया, आई टू निकालना है तो सेकंड कॉलम रिप्लेस करो, आई वन निकालना है तो फर्स्ट, इससे रिप्लेस करेंगे वो वोल्टेज से, सिंपल कैंसिल को डाल लेना फिर ना, दो इक्वेशन दो नो एक्सप्रेशन निकालो,
हाँ Just to calculate VF upon V naught.
Calculate VF upon V naught only in terms of R, S and
might have got this expression. Yeah, see here. Hope everyone get this. Del 2 upon del, how much is this? I2 na? I2 kitna aaya? V not? V not S? V not bias? V not? I think V not bias, you know. ठीक है? No, you just tell me expression that you would get for VF upon V not. How much is that? One upon three plus. You tell me that. Three plus. RSC. RSC plus one upon. Is that okay? Everyone got this expression?
Yes.
ठीक है. Now see. We want the now ये क्या है output sorry input you see this okay. You see this diagram. See we got 180 degree phase shift here. Now this to this ratio VF to V naught. This should again give me 180 degree phase shift. All right. You should give me 180 degree phase shift. In order to get that 180 degree phase shift, the imaginary part should be zero, right? So the imaginary part there in the denominator
What is it, beta here? See, I'm taking this omega r's equal to 1. And this is nothing but beta, right? V upon V naught is beta. V upon V naught is beta. So, what is this omega r's? Omega r's is 1. If omega r's is 1, what is this going to be? Imaginary part is going to be 0. So that was the criteria that was, that it still was the criteria to get the one entity of additional phase shift, isn't it? Beta is going to be 1 by 3, as beta is going to be 1 by 3, can you tell me what value of A should satisfy this? Of course, A must be greater than? Therefore, what does it indicate? A means here, the gain of the common source amplifier. Always ensure the gain of the common source amplifier to be greater than 3. If that is done, our aim is satisfied. We can get the oscillator. Alright? Okay. I think I skipped the steps here. See, this is a complex expression. Alright? The complex expression, this is the ratio. In fact, it's a transfer function. This we call it as a transfer function. The ratio of output by input is nothing but a system function or the transfer function. This being a complex function, it is having some magnitude and the phase. That magnitude indicates the factor by which the signal will get attenuated. The phase indicates the factor by which the signal will get shifted. Phase shift indicates the shift in the time. Is that okay? Now, how 180 degrees, how making this imaginary part is going to make that 180 degree phase shift is because how are you calculating the phase shift, by the way? How are you calculating the phase of any complex number? Tan inverse, do you know that?
All right, so so this is all about RC phase shift oscillator. This is not the only variant of the oscillator. There are other oscillators also. The others are, I'm giving those also as a homework. The other variants of the oscillators are, see, I'm giving these homeworks means I can ask questions on them. The other variants of the oscillators are Hartley, Colpit, Wien bridge, the crystal oscillator. Most widely used is this crystal.
It's a crystal oscillator, okay? If you have an electronic device, it must have this kind of oscillator, alright?
Crystal oscillator. So, just because that being very important, let me give a glimpse of the crystal oscillator, what is inside that or not. Alright? So, crystal oscillator is having a piezoelectric crystal. Nothing but sphatic, okay? A specific, you know what is crystal, okay? So, this is a kind of salt, okay, Rochelle's salt, that is what it is said. Let me draw that. What is that salt? Do you know what is the material being used? Yeah, quartz, but this is something. Huh? Spark. No, material being used. Rochelle's salt. Do you know that? Quartz, yes. So how the quartz operate and all that we are going to see. But let me tell you that there is something, some physical device which is capable of generating the oscillations when we give some pressure to that device. Okay, suppose this is the oscillator. Assume that this is some device. Okay, this device is such that if we give some pressure or some electrical signals, it will generate oscillations, and other way around. Okay, if we give some vibration, it will generate electrical signals. If we give electrical signals, it will generate vibrations. Okay, how and all we are going to see that. Just keep patience. So let's have a look at the video. I don't know if the sound will be, but I will turn on the subtitles.